Cogdell, we're going to begin tonight with an 80-year-old woman violently attacked in her own home.
What deputies say the suspect did will shock you. News 4's Nigel Robertson joins us now with a story. Nigel.
Carol and Michael, deputies say the suspect is now back in jail after being released just 2 weeks ago. On Sunday, deputies say he attacked an elderly woman, pulled her phone line out from the wall, even tore off her medical alert necklace just so she couldn't call for help.
Deputies call what happened here in this Greenville County neighborhood shocking.
He's been charged with attempted murder, armed robbery, burglary first degree, kidnapping, and criminal sexual conduct first degree.
Deputy Matt Smith is talking about this man, Charles Mitchell Finley Jr. Sunday, investigators say Finley knocked on the door of an elderly woman he knew and asked to use the bathroom.
Victim is, you know, an 80-year-old female and was fairly easily overpowered by this individual. He, like I said, armed himself with a hammer, was able to bound her with duct tape, and eventually choked her out to the point of unconsciousness.
Deputies say while she was passed out on the floor, the victim was sexually assaulted. After being treated at a hospital, the victim was able to pick out Finley as the person who attacked her, and deputies tracked him down, but it wasn't easy.
No, sir, there was a brief foot chase involved, but they did capture him.
But look at this. Investigators say Charles Finley has a long list of prior convictions with just Greenville County alone. Convictions for burglary, grand larceny, petty larceny, possession of drug paraphernalia, theft of electrical current, and giving false information to a police officer. He is now in the Greenville County Detention Center being held on no bond.
Again, according to county records, Finley was just released from the Greenville County Detention Center on February 13th. He pleaded guilty to second-degree burglary and petty larceny charges. He was sentenced to 7 years, suspended to 5 years probation, and was released. He is now looking at least 60 years on the new charges if convicted.